If you've never tried cooking for whatever reason you may have, be it you're too scared inside the kitchen, feeling lazy, or maybe just too busy at work, I have the simplest dishes that will change your mind about laboring inside the kitchen. Pasta is always an easy and safe way to learn how to cook. And I will prove to you how foolproof it is with these two pasta dishes that I will be teaching you today. One is a staple at our home. It's called the aglio olio, which you can make under 10 minutes. And another well-loved family recipe is my baked rigotoni with parmesan cream. This is a pinch of Portia. Do you know that there are around 350 kinds of pastas? And the general rule to which pasta shape goes to which sauce is that the long skinny ones like your spaghettini, your linguine, or vermicelli goes well with your cream-based sauces, oil-based, or light seafood sauces. Like the thicker ones like your pappardelle or your fettuccine goes well with the rich, thicker meat sauces. This rigatoni right here, like all the other two pastas, like the penne and the macaroni, goes well with a hearty vegetable, meat sauces as well, and baked cheese dishes. And that is exactly what we will be making today. Baked rigatoni with parmesan cream. We will start by preparing our pasta noodles, the rigatoni. I have made this earlier today, which I reduce the cooking time to 2 to 3 minutes because we will still be baking these noodles later on. Okay, let's start making the sauce. I have your hot pan. I poured my olive oil already. And then we're gonna add in my chopped onions. These are two large white onions. Our minced garlic. Lots of it if you want. Next is our beef cubes. If you will take a look at this one, it's starting to brown, and we're ready to add in our ground beef. Then you can add your herbs if you want to add herbs like your oregano or thyme. You can do that. I have some here. It's time to pour in our bottled passata. Passata is actually just diced tomatoes, like a simple tomato sauce. I'm gonna turn down my heat, cover this, and wait maybe around 15 to 20 minutes until all the juices come out and the pasta sauce is fully cooked. Now, while our sauce is cooking, I will start making the parmesan cream. I will turn on my heat, just on low fire. We don't like to burn our cheese. Then I have here 2 cups of cooking cream. And then I have here 1.5 cups of grated parmesan cheese, okay? Then I just mix this and just wait for it to all melt into your cream. I think my sauce is ready and it's time to add in our pasta noodles. Now I'm ready to start plating this on my baking dish. Okay, this is kind of just like making your lasagna, all right? I'm gonna add our parmesan cream. And then now we're gonna add our buffalo mozzarella. So these are really stretchy. You can buy this in your grocery store or any deli. And then our grated parmesan cheese. I'm gonna put this inside my preheated oven at 300 degrees for 20 minutes or just until all the cheese have melted and the top is nice and golden brown. And while we're waiting for this, I'm gonna teach you how to make my simple and staple aglio olio. I'm gonna turn on my heat. And then I'm gonna pour in my olive oil. We're gonna add in our garlic. And then we start adding in our cherry tomatoes. Then this is my secret ingredient, the rum. So this will give a nice sweet flavor to your aglio olio. So I'm gonna pour this in, and then I'm gonna tip the rim until I get that flambe. So you flambe away, all right? So the alcohol is all gone, and all the sweetness is inside this fat. Now I'm ready to add in my noodles. Just quickly mix this together. Make sure the noodles are as hot as your sauce, your garlic, and your tomatoes. Our pasta is done. I'm ready to plate. Ooh, hot. I'm ready to plate this. Okay. See, all under 10 minutes. Add some parmesan cheese, and then basil on top. And this is my simple and staple, aglio olio. Okay, my rigatoni must be done by now. I'm gonna take it out from my oven. Okay, let's try the rigatoni. Look at all the cheese, all the mozzarella. No wonder this is my family's favorite. The creaminess that comes from the cooking cream and the parmesan cheese, plus that smoky flavor. I know, so sarap. It's really good. I love it. I'm getting the entire plate. All right, this is the aglio olio, fresh tomatoes, garlic, rum. Okay, let's do. You know, the juice of the tomato just bursts it inside my mouth. It tastes so good, it's sweet. I like also the flavor of the rum, plus the garlic. Ah, definitely a winner at home, okay? Make this, don't forget. I hope I dispelled all your fears and hesitations about cooking with these two simple pasta dishes. So start cooking and stop making excuses, okay? This is a pinch of Portia.